All right, so now we're gonna get our back table set up before we drape our patient. And in this pack, we have not only a table drape, but a patient drape. So I'm gonna start by opening the table drape, being careful that I don't contaminate it as I go. I'm gonna open the side towards me first, slide my instruments, and then open the side away from me. And as I do that, I can actually wrap my hand under the drape so that if I were to be too close to the wall, I actually don't contaminate my hand. And now some of the stuff I don't need, so I'm just gonna kinda lay it out. We're gonna get our suction hose, all of our little clips and suction tip. We've got a sharps container, and I'm gonna get rid of this, and I'm just gonna toss that off to the side here. My instruments are here. I'm careful to lift just from the inside edge. This is all sterile, and set those on the back of my table here. And now I can get all of my drapes unfolded and ready to go. So I'm gonna open up my drapes and lay them out with the sticky side up. So I'm all prepared for draping. And these drapes come with an edge that's already folded over, and that's gonna be the edge that's gonna contact my patient. Okay. And this prevents me from contaminating them as I open them up here on top of my drapes. Okay, so now I'm gonna take my first drape. I'm gonna pull the adhesive protective sheath off and drop that. I'm now gonna wrap my fingers around so that they're protected in the drape, and so that when I lay this drape on the patient, I'm not gonna contaminate myself and touch my glove. I'm gonna put my first drape on cranially here and try and just touch that drape down. And it's okay to shift the drape a little bit away from the sterile field, but I never wanna go towards. My next drape, I'm gonna do on the caudal aspect. Typically these, because they stay a little bit better on the patient. Again, protecting myself, leaning away as I drape. And now I'm gonna drape the side towards me, and that's gonna give me a little protection for when I have to lean across the table for the next drape. Again, wrapping the drape around my hands to protect. Now before I do this next drape, I need to drape out the prepuce. I'm doing it now because I have a little bit of a barrier here, right, in case I lean against it. But I'm typically going to just grab the tip of the prepuce with the towel clamp, and then I lateralize the prepuce, open up the towel clamp, and then pinch a little bit of that skin in with the towel clamp, and then I'm just gonna drop it, right? I don't wanna touch it. And now I can put my final drape on and drape out the tip of that prepuce since we don't need it for this portion of the surgery. If we were doing a urinary surgery, we may wanna keep that in our field. And then now, this drape gets a little bit trickier, but I basically just wanna protect my fingers. And really, everything's draped in, so I should be good. And I'm just gonna reach across the table and then drape so that the prepuce is covered. Great. Now I can place my towel clamps that are gonna hold those drapes in place. Even though the drapes have the adhesive strip, those adhesive strips don't tend to work very well. So I'm gonna clip right out the corners of the drape, clipping both drapes and a little pinch of skin. And again, leaning away as I clamp the far side. And since this is kind of a long incision, I will clamp kind of midway down as well to prevent that drape from pulling back too much. Careful not to go into that dog's splenic mass with that one. Lastly, I'm gonna put my patient drape on top. And for the patient drape, if I have a non-sterile assistant, they can help me with this. I'm gonna open the patient drape and lay it on top of the patient. I can help my non-sterile assistant by lifting the very edge of the drape, and she can grab the underside of the drape so as not to contaminate while she grabs. And then we're gonna pull towards us and away from us as we open up this sterile drape. As I do that, I wanna make sure my hand is protected from the other side so I don't contaminate myself on my anesthesia team. And we've got some non-penetrating clamps I'm going to use on the outer drape here to secure it so it doesn't slide from side to side. I'm going to go ahead and hook up my suction that I'm going to need during surgery. For this, I'm going to use a non-penetrating clamp. I'm going to grasp half of this hose so I keep enough for my surgery team here, and I'm going to throw the other half over. And then I'm just going to clamp a little pinch of the drape around that tubing. I haven't yet. Go ahead. We're going to open up some additional clamps. I'm going to make sure I reach in. This one's a little tricky because they try and slide away. These are non-penetrating towel clamps that we can use on the outside of the drape. And then I'm going to use these light handle covers as well. I'm going to put these guys on. So before I put these on, because it can be a little bit tricky, I'm just going to fold over the outer edge to give my hand a little bit of protection. And then slide that over my light handle, being careful only to handle the lower portion so I don't accidentally contaminate my hand. And I'll do the same thing on this light handle cover. And we're doing this at the end when everything is already draped so we don't contaminate. Now I can cut a hole in my drape with some Mayo scissors. Just feeling for those inner towel clamps here. And I can cut a hole in my drape. And then if I want, if my drape tends to slide sometimes as it does, I can use these non-penetrating towel clamps to secure that outer drape. And that's what I'm gonna do here, is use these non-penetrating towel clamps on the corners. A lot of times you only need four, but we could certainly put some on the sides as well too. All right, so lastly, I would just need to get my cautery handpiece hooked up. Again, I'll toss the non-sterile end. And in this case, I'm going to grab the little holster to secure to my drape, with a non-penetrating towel clamp. And then I can hook this to the plastic holster to secure. And now I have a little place for that to rest where it won't fall onto the floor. I can also pop the end of my suction tip in there, suction tubing in there as well. And we're ready for surgery.